Steve Dotto here. Thanks for joining me today. Now, on my weekly radio show, once a month, we do a feature that we call App Thursday, where I get a bunch of friends together and we talk about what we think are the coolest apps that we have on our mobile devices. And every month, we pick a winner, and that winner wins a prize, and we basically look at cool apps through that. Now, once a year, we take all of the coolest apps that we looked at all year and we create an App of the Year contest. Now, you're probably going to be watching this video after we've already decided who the winner is. So you can drop by our website to see which app actually won this year. But I wanted to show you a few of my favorite apps that we looked at this year that I think you might be interested in. Now, regardless of where you live, the Canadian Red Cross app is one that you might look at having on your phone. If you live in Canada and you are in an emergency situation, they will actually walk you through what to do in case of emergency if you're dealing with somebody in a potentially life-threatening situation. But for all of us, they've got this great database of what you should be doing to help people in case of any of these medical situations. So if you have a friend that was stung by a wasp and you're not too sure what you should be doing about it to help them out, you can go in and you can navigate through and they give you a little tutorial on what you can be doing and how you should handle that particular situation, as well as warnings and related items, like if somebody starts to go into anaphylaxis as a result, you know how to recognize the signs of that sort of stuff. And they have that for a huge range of situations that we can find ourselves in. And if we take a look down here at the bottom, they also don't just have this dialogue of things that you can do at the moment, but there's all of these preparation things that you should be doing in your home to prepare in case there's an earthquake, creating an emergency kit, and all of those sorts of things you can do preparation. They've got information for here as well. Plus, I really like this, they've got a series of tests. So you can see just what your medical knowledge is in the case of minor medical situations, or I guess even major medical situations. It's a free app from the Canadian Red Cross. I think it's one of the outstanding apps that we looked at this year. Now let's go from the serious to the more fun. Let's kind of jump around a little bit. And the next thing I want to show you is an app called Strutt, which is a game that all of my friends started playing. It kind of harkens back to, you know, the days of the computer games where they would where as you explored worlds, the world would kind of unveil underneath you. And what Strutt does is it takes a Google map of where you are, and then it sets it against geolocation. And as you travel around, it takes a second for it to resolve because there's a lot of processing going on. But as you drive around or walk around or bike around, it reveals tiles. It reveals the tiles under the areas that you are in. So the whole idea is for you to uncover as many tiles as you can. And you can see it's clearing up now in the area that I am. And it uses one thing about this particular game. It's free, but it's really resource intensive. When you use Strutt as you're driving around, your iPhone or your will get so hot because it's using the GPSs in all of the different geolocation tools in order to figure out exactly where you are and what you're doing. So you can see there that in my community, I've been, you know, obviously been fairly, I've exposed most of the tiles in my community. So there's a little competition going amongst all of my friends about who can uncover the most tiles. And they have, of course, leader lists and all those sorts of things available to you as well. So Strutt is a... it's just kind of a fun game. It's sort of a game that tells you where you've been. And you'll see people trying to even using it on airplanes and stuff like that. Truckers have a big advantage because they can just use it as they're driving around on their job. But you can see in the city of Vancouver, I've covered a lot of the city, but there's still a lot of places in the city that I haven't gone. So Strutt is a fun app that we looked at this season and is one of our competitors for App of the Year. Next on the list is Songza. It is a music streaming app which is really growing in popularity because A, it's free, B, it runs on almost everything. Now, I first discovered it when I started to set up my Sonos sound system. I've got a Sonos wireless sound system here in my home, and Songza is one of the services on it. And I started to use Songza for streaming music, and they've got such good playlists that Since we've set it up, and that's over a year ago that I set up my Sonos sound system. Since we've set it up, we've barely touched our own iTunes music library, which I have thousands of songs in, because it's so much work creating your own playlists in iTunes or in any music manager. But they do a great job of creating playlists. You see it here. I'm showing you it right now on an Android phone, but it also runs on the iPhone. It runs on all the different platforms, and even on the web. There's a version that you can run streaming from a web browser. So it is an app which, to me, as far as all of the different music apps that I've played with, Songza is the one that has stuck with me. The free nature of it, and they're starting to add advertisements to it a little bit, so you're getting a little bit of advertising. I haven't seen it myself personally. I haven't actually had any ads running, but friends of mine have told me that they've had ads running. Let's take a look at it as well now on the iPhone, because you've seen it now in the Android phone. You've seen, you know, kind of the screen running through. You've seen it on the website. So here it is now running on my iPhone. And, you know, we're kind of getting close to Christmas now as we're doing this. So I can take a look and I can just start playing through the biggest Christmas hits, like classic Christmas songs. And it will stream on your phone. You can, of course, send it to any of your devices. So you've got some really nice flexibility as far as where it's going to be playing and how it's going to be playing. I don't know if you can hear that. It's actually streaming through because I've got my iPhone air playing to my computer. It's playing through my computer speakers. It's putting me in the Christmas spirit for sure. Songza. If you haven't tried it out yet, it's worth exploring, especially if you're using one of the paid for apps. If you're using one of the paid apps, it's well worth taking a look at, because it's one of the definite finalists for our app of the year. It's, I think, one of the leading contenders. Next up, let me show you what's up next. The next app that I want to talk about is another serious app, and that is LastPass, password protection, and it's a password manager. Now, I'm not going to go into a long demo here because we did a great demo of LastPass, which I am linking to right here, right now. So you can just click and watch this demo where I show you the whole ecosystem of LastPass, from using it on your computer to using it on your mobility device. But LastPass for me is one of the tools that I rely on every single day, and it's definitely a contender, as far as I'm concerned, for app of the year. Now, completely out of left field is the next app. It's called TalkTo. Now, TalkTo is an app that allows you to send text messages to retail establishments in your area and ask them questions. So what it does is it bypasses that phoning up a retailer, and it's especially useful if you're calling to look for a hard-to-find item or one that's selling very well or a unique size or something like that. So you send a text to a retailer, and then the TalkTo server, they actually have services that they either deal with the people by texting and making sure that the store texts you back, or they actually have real people that will call and follow up for you and then send you a text on whether or not your items that you're asking about are there. So it's great for in the evening as you're going along and you don't want to go on the phone and just wait on hold forever to find out about that unique Christmas gift, that unique present for your significant other. So I sent a couple of sample texts or samples through. I just asked my local Home Depot and local IKEA if there were LED lights or if they had them on sale, thinking that I'm going to be renovating my house and putting in LED lights. And so I sent it through in the evening. I got a text right away back saying that they will get back to me when the store opens. They told me what time to expect the text back. And indeed, I got text back from both of them the next day telling me what items they had on sale and what they had in inventory and giving me advice. Now, I don't know whether that came from the TalkTo people or from the stores themselves. I don't really care. I got the information I needed, and it works for all local retailers, and it works both in Android and in iOS. It's called TalkTo, and that is definitely a real huge time saver. The last app I'm going to show you is one that I think is really cool, and unfortunately I can't do an actual demo for you, but it's called DSLR Dashboard. A DSLR Dashboard is an app that it requires a special cable to connect, but once you get the app and the cable, you can connect your smartphone, in this case only an Android phone, it doesn't work on iPhone, you can connect it to your digital camera, and then it allows you to manage all camera controls from your smartphone. So you've got a cable, so you can set all of the exposures, you can set all the settings, you can preview it all on your smartphone or your mobility device, and you can control your camera with it. It's only available on Google Play. I think it's 99 cents. It's not incredibly expensive, but it does a great job of managing all the major camera brands and allowing you to remote manage your DSLR using this app. And there's a lot more information here on the website, but bottom line is it is a if you're a serious photographer, this gives you a much larger screen and a much more comfortable environment to work in managing the controls of your digital camera. So that's our top those are the top apps that I think of for this year. We have a few more in our contest. So the one that actually wins, if you drop by and visit our site, might be a different one than I've shown you, but we've got DSLR Dashboard. We've got the Canadian Red Cross app, which is outstanding. I don't care where you live, download the Canadian Red Cross app. It might end up saving somebody's life. We have Strutt, which is just fun. It's uncovering tiles as you travel around. But make sure you have an alternate power supply when you're using that. So in the car, I always plug in my phone when I'm using it because it uses up juice like nobody's business. TalkTo, which will save you tons of time on hold, allowing you to text all of your local retailers, ask them questions, and have them get back to you in a timely fashion. LastPass, which will create a much more secure environment and manage all your passwords, saving you both time and making your life more secure. And finally, Songza, which just adds music to your life for free. They do a phenomenal job on their playlist management. It is my go-to music app. And that's it for this particular video from us. If you like this video, please give us a like. Tell the world that we do a good job here at Dotto Tech, and please subscribe to our videos. Every week I produce new productivity videos. I hope that you find them valuable. I certainly appreciate you spending your time with me today. I'm Steve Dotto. We'll catch you soon.